bisect. Bisect is like, you know, the bees, bees. Bisect, think about a situation when you have this. Let me just ask you. Suppose you have a project, all right, where you have commits. You have one commit, like that. You have, let's say, some 50 commits. So now this is commit number one, this is commit number n. Okay, you notice that the nth commit has a bug, and you know that commit number one does not have a bug. You don't know where it was introduced, you want to find it. What do you do?
Blame.
So how do you do blame? I don't know where it was introduced. There's a bug.
But you know what the bug is.
Yeah, I know what the bug is. But I don't know exactly where in the code this was introduced. Because it's changed so much. There's like, let's say, 1,000 commits or something. What do you do?
Resetting and testing.
Huh?
Or do I reset?
You don't know the commit. You want to find the commit.
Start with one with resetting.
No, you can search a string, right?
No, I don't know where it was introduced. This was a byproduct of something which my tests didn't catch. This is true.
Or you can go faster, like a binary.
No, I don't know where the bug was introduced. Like somewhere between 1 and n, this bug was introduced. I don't know where. That's the problem. With Git, you can use bisect. Bisect basically automates this process of binary search. You can tell him, like, this is the bad one, this is the good one. Find me the problem. It'll figure it out for you. Okay, this is like really awesome. I'll show you a demo with it. That should drive home the point. Let's create a simple project. This was stolen by Mercurial and others, let's say. A bisect demo. Okay, Git init. Clean repository with nothing. Okay. I'm going to create a file called trial0.c. And I have something include stdio int main printf. So a simple C program that just prints hello world. Okay. So rm. And I'm going to git add trial0.c git commit. Alright. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add some commits, let's say for I in 1, 2, let's say 20 commits. To echo. So now I have a situation where I have one initial commit and 20 commits. Okay. Now this is artificial, but let's take this file once again and I make a mistake in this. Okay. So if I try to compile this now, GCC trials0.c, it will fail because the semicolon is missing. And let's say we add this and we say git commit minus m. This is the bad commit. I should. Okay, this is the commit that we're supposed to find. And now we'll add some more. Let's say, how many do you want? 100?
If you have a commit message like that.
Yeah, no, that's the demo. Okay, so now we are at what? Git log minus minus 1 line. This is the history of the project. Okay, we have so many commits. How many are there? 123 commits. Okay. I try typing this message. It's not working.
Who knows?
Yeah, who broke it? Somewhere in these 123 commits, it broke. The question is to find which one. So what do I do? Say git log minus minus one line. And I go all the way down here. The initial commit is here, as readme.txt is here. You can temporarily check out like this. You get into what's called a detached head state. Detached head state means, usually what does head point to? It points to another reference, which points to a commit. If you give checkout directly to a commit, head will directly point to that commit. It's not attached to another actual reference. So if I make some commit over here, it will come, but there's no way to reach that. So this is, you know, you can do this if you don't want to actually do any work over there, if you just want to see that commit. It's called detached head. So let's say I try typing this here. It works. Okay, so I know that this commit is good. And I know, I go to master, git checkout master. And I say, I know that master is bad and this is good. Right? This is good and master is bad. So what you can do is you can say git bisect star. And you can give the bad commit. What is the bad commit? Master. And the good commit. So you commit this one. So it's saying start bisecting. Bisect means do a binary search between master and this. The master is the bad commit and this is the good commit. Somewhere in between there will be one commit where the failure first occurred. Find that for me. Okay? So let's do this. So it does something and it says it bisected 60 revisions. It's gone halfway. Okay? And it's asking you. It's taken you to some commit. So it's asking you whether it's good or bad. So you type something like GCC trials or whatever else. It breaks. So you say git bisect bad. So it goes somewhere else. And you again try GCC trials or whatever else. It's still bad. So I say git bisect bad. Again it goes. Again I try. This is good. So I say git bisect good. Try it again. GCC trials. It's git bisect bad. So try it again. This is good. So I say git bisect good. I say git. I'll say GCC trials 0.c. It's good. So I say git bisect good. Now I say GCC trials 0.c. It breaks. So I say git bisect bad. There. Okay. Fine. One sec. This is one thing I want to do. So you can do it like this, okay, as if this wasn't enough, alright, as if this wasn't enough, what they do is they said git bisect star, you can say this, start, and then you can say git, forget the example, you can say git bisect run, and the test is gcc trial 0.c, it'll actually do this for you automatically and find it.
I don't see that.
Let's do it once again. Get bisect. So you just like this thing. We say git bisect start. Okay. Now the thing is, I have an automated test to check whether this commit is good or bad. So then there's no need for me to actually manually run it each time. You tell git this is the test. Figure out the bad commit for me. So tell me the place where this is failing. So you say git bisect run and the test is gcc trial result.c. So 123 commits, right? It found exactly where the bad commit is. So there's two things to be said. One thing, you should have good tests. If you have good tests, you can pick up stuff like this very easily. Second thing, this is one big advantage of having all the data locally. If this was subversion, not going to work. You want to go back to a previous repository, fetch from the server. Come back here, fetch from the server. Too much. Return value. GCC can return non-zero or fail. Most Unix tools will return.
What was the command? Git bisect?
Run.
And the?
Test. The GCC, like the name of the command followed by the R. It's awesome, no?
So it fails when it finds a zero value.
Yeah, so if any command which returns a non-zero value is failure, according to Unix.
Okay, non-zero is failure.
Yeah, non-zero. Zero means success. So there's slash bin slash true, which is do nothing successful. And there's slash bin slash false, which is do nothing unsuccessful.
Okay.
So it doesn't do anything, but it returns zero, which means it's true. It doesn't do anything, but it returns false. Alright, so that's bisect.